top story. It's day one of Victoria's snap 5-day lockdown, the second in just weeks, the fifth since the pandemic began. You all tired of it? The state's total number of infections growing to 18 cases, the outbreak leaking from Sydney's Bondi cluster, which began 1 month ago.
We have team coverage around the country this morning. Let's go first to today. Melbourne reporter Isabella Stashkovsky, who's at a testing clinic in Albert Park. Isa, there are now more than 100 exposure site alerts. What are testing queues like there this morning?
Well, Ali, thousands of people are going to have to get tested today, but queues right across Victoria are quieter than we've seen them in previous days and in previous outbreaks. I want to show you what it looks like here at the Albert Park testing site. This isn't far from the MCG, which is a key exposure site. You can see that there are about 30 cars quite far away from where we are, a few more trickling in now. But in previous days, by this time, cars have been snaking out of this area for kilometres. I can also tell you we have teams not too far away at the Melbourne Showgrounds. We were there yesterday. This time yesterday, there were hundreds of cars. At the Melbourne Showgrounds, there are around 15 right now. We have harsher restrictions now in Victoria than in New South Wales. We're back to that system of 5 reasons to leave your home. So care, food, exercise, work, or of course to go and get vaccinated. We also have school closures, business closures, hospitality is back to takeaway only, and we can't leave our homes past that 5-kilometre radius. And let me tell you, people in Melbourne this morning are really feeling it.
Not good, not good. It's not healthy.
We're just frustrated to be here again.
We don't want to be in lockdown, but if we're going to be, we need to really rally like we have before to do the right thing and get out of this as quickly as possible.
There was also a large protest last night in the CBD. Take a look at these pictures. You can see large groups of people congregating near Flinders Street. They were marching towards Parliament, chanting, "Sack Dan Andrews." Police are aware. They say at this stage, no arrests have been made.
Yeah, there's real angst out there. Thanks, Isa.
Cleaners at Sydney's Westmead Hospital are refusing to clean the COVID ward until they've been properly protected. Today, correspondent Lara Vella is at Liverpool Hospital. Lara, it comes as new cases were recorded in the healthcare community.
Carl, it is slowly starting to feel like our healthcare system across our west and southwest is buckling under the enormous pressure of this latest outbreak. We've got 3 paramedics from Liverpool that have now tested positive to the virus, and we're hearing reports this morning that as many as 70 ambos might have to go into isolation after being linked to those 3 confirmed cases. We've got a specialist here at Liverpool Hospital that has also tested positive. They also worked at Campbelltown Hospital while infectious. And this morning, there is a standoff at Westmead Hospital with more than 200 cleaners refusing to go into the COVID ward because they say that they are not being given access to proper PPE, Carl, things like hair nets and shoe coverings. This was the secretary of the HSU on Nine's 2GB.
My concern is a cleaner is just as important as any other clinician, and they make up a complementary workforce within the health setting. And they're sort of, in my view, they're looking at second-class citizens.
Carl, speaking of cleaners, a contract cleaner has also tested positive at Minchinbury Manor. That is an aged care facility at Rudy Hill. We understand that the facility today is in lockdown. Fortunately, though, staff and residents, 90% of them have been vaccinated. 5 close contacts of that confirmed case are now in isolation.
Lara, thank you.
Health authorities are concerned about Sydney's West with a large majority of yesterday's cases recorded there. Today, Sydney reporter Gabriel Boyle is at a 24-hour testing clinic in Fairfield. Gabby, teachers in the area can now get vaccinated.
That's correct, Charles, and that's all in a bid to protect the people that we need to go to work. I tell you what, they're doing an amazing job here at the testing clinic this morning. They've got 8 stations set up here as people move through. It's a slow but steady stream of people turning out to get their 3-day test because, of course, the rule is still in place that you need to be tested every 3 days if you're to work outside of these local areas. 65 fresh cases found yesterday. 46 of those are in Sydney's southwest, and that is why priority vaccines are being shuffled out to these areas as quickly as possible. Teachers and aged care workers will be the priority, but not just teachers themselves, everyone that works at schools to make sure that the entire adult population is protected to get our kids back into classrooms as quickly as possible. That vaccine hub will be set up in Prairiewood and effective from today. Charles.
Thank you.
Infectious diseases experts say a snap lockdown could be essential in Queensland if cases continue to grow. Today's Rhys D'Alessandro is outside one of Brisbane's new exposure sites at Annerley. Rhys, restrictions in the state have been extended.
Yeah, that's right, Ali. Good morning to you. That's because of three new cases in Queensland yesterday, one of which visited the Chemist Warehouse behind us here at Annerley this morning and also across Ipswich Road, the Woolworths at Annerley as well. That is why restrictions are being extended, including Brisbane's mask mandate that's been in place for 2 weeks now, another week from this morning. We've been asking locals here how they feel about the extension. Here's what they had to say.
Good to keep the mask. There's no drums with that. We've all got to keep safe because of Delta variant that's around at the moment, so yeah, I think it's a good idea because it can happen anywhere, as we know. Over the last 18 months, you can be anywhere, anytime, and you can be exposed, so as long as you're wearing a mask, I guess it's the best you can do.
Ali, this is the families of 480 NRL players who've been relocated to Queensland to keep the season alive. I've been told overnight they won't be able to come into Queensland as planned this weekend. They've received a letter from the NRL, and I'll read some of that for you now. It says the Queensland government would now like more individual information and more information about our quarantine facility and COVID-safe plan before they approve our submission. We are hopeful you will make it to the Gold Coast within a week. Ali, I can tell you some of the players are skeptical of that this morning.
Let's see. Thanks, Rhys.
Queensland Premier Anastasia Palaszczuk will fly to Tokyo on Sunday in her final bid for the Brisbane 2032 Olympic Games. The Premier will have just 45 minutes to make her last pitch to the IOC, with a decision to be made on Wednesday night. It comes despite more than 125,000 people signing a petition calling for the Premier to be stopped from leaving the country.